Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. I've called you here this afternoon to address the persistent and consistent unfair association of my person and myself and my character with the issue of the late Kuria'S Msandu'S of IBC. And related to that issue, to address the issue of insecurity in general, especially within the current political environmental climate within which we are operating. For the last a good part of 2018-2019, since this very sad and unfortunate incident of the disappearance and the subsequent death of Kuria'S Msandu'S happened, I've had to live with a barrage of innuendos, accusations, and suspicions that linked me to the disappearance and the death of Kuria'S Msandu'S. Particularly so because at that particular time, as you all know and as you recall, that I posted a photograph of the vehicle, and I repeat, the vehicle of the late Kuria'S Msandu'S somewhere in Resamo. I want to set the record straight as follows. On that particular day, I recall it was a Sunday, the media was reporting again and again, I think for more than one day, that Kuria'S Msandu'S had disappeared and that he could not be found and neither his vehicle could be found. And then Citizen TV circulated a photo of his vehicle. And there was a lot of tension and a lot of speculation in the country. On that material day, I was in Murang'a County, where I was leading a campaign known as Mbele Iko Sawa for Jubilee Party, alongside leaders from Jubilee leaders from Murang'a County. As we were winding up our campaign activities around 6 o'clock, I got a call from two ladies through a certain media personality who was in our entourage. And they told us that the vehicle that is being circulated, that is bringing out of political heat, has been found somewhere in Resam. I remember I was in the company of, among other people, the current women from Murang'a, Sabina Cheve, and we consulted and said, as responsible leaders, once you get information about disappearance of a vehicle, and that vehicle has been found and you have gotten that information, what do you do? So we did two things. One, we called the OCPD of Kasarani Police Station, even before we went to the scene, and we told him, Bwana OCPD, we have received this call from these people that this vehicle that has been circulated as missing has been found. And we wanted you to send officers so that we can show them where the people who are calling us are, and we leave the matter in your hands. And so they agreed. And I remember we had stopped for dinner somewhere in Dika at a hotel known as Blue Post Hotel. We proceeded to where the leaders were directing us with the Honorable Sabina Chega and other people. And on the way, we had to stop and ensure that the police were with us. So the OCPD mobilized his officers, and together with the police, we followed the calls and until to the point whereby we found the vehicle. And the police confirmed they have seen the vehicle, they have received the vehicle, and we left it at that. In fact, we didn't leave until even some people from media, remember Royal Media Service, sent a journalist by the name of Ken Wakuraya. And we didn't leave until, one, the police were on site, and two, that the media were there. Now, subsequent to that, I think either the following day or within 2 days, let's say within 48 hours, we were summoned by CID, Nairobi area, myself and Honorable Sabina Cheve, and the leaders. We recorded a statement. We are talking about 2 years and 4 months. Nobody, neither the media nor those people who are in social media have ever bothered to go and ask the police whether we recorded a statement with the fact that I have repeated herein. Instead, what we have encountered is daily accusations. And you know, we are human. And myself, I'm a leader. And I'm a parent. I'm a father. And it's not good. And I want this statement to put a stop forthwith to any further association of myself with this particular issue. Because within 48 hours, I recorded a statement. The way we found the vehicle, the way we were called, we produced the leaders who had called us. We went with the police. We recorded all that. We left it at the matter of CID. And actually, the police were satisfied with our statement. And nobody has ever asked us or followed us on that particular issue. And neither have the public, nor the media, nor anyone followed up. I do not think it is fair. We all of us have got a reputation, and we have got responsibilities as leaders, most important as parents. It is not good and it's not fair. And I really wish and want to beg that people from today stop associating me or the Honorable Sabina Chege with this particular issue, because we are doing what a responsible citizen and a responsible leader should do. Once you get information about a crime or about any information which you think is helpful to a matter that is of public concern or investigation, what are we supposed to do? Keep quiet? Many people would have kept quiet, gone home, assumed nothing happened. So instead of us getting accurate about reporting crime, because failure to report information within which you have in possession of is actually abetting a crime. And I think you are responsible citizens and you are responsible leaders. And I think everyone, even those of us who you think that we are immune to the kind of name calling and besmirching and character assassination, no one is immune. No one is happy with this kind of a, like human life. Nothing for me is worth taking somebody's life. Nothing. And nobody should wish that somebody's life is taken, even your worst enemies. So with the same breath, I want to ask you media not to really be dropping balls, because that is exactly what Kenyan media is good at. You just pick an issue, within one day, you say that Kenyans have a short memory. But it is a media, because before something is investigated or we get to the depth of the matter, you have abandoned it and you have gone to another issue. So much as we blame the public, I also, you know, I accuse the press. You know, I really put this on your doorstep, because this issue, how many people have followed up from the media about what happened to the investigation about Chris Msandu'? How many people from the opposition, which is now in government, have followed up on this issue? How many people from the social media and civil society have followed up on this issue? Yet you take an innocent person who just volunteered information that got into their position with this particular issue. I don't know what you expected from me today. But I think the most important thing is this indictment of media, of the opposition, of social media, and of civil society at not getting to the bottom of the matter. We had previous cases before, like the case of Crispin Odhiambo Mbai, which, you know, died and, you know, went into thin air, and many other instances. Now, recently, I was saddened, and this is now coming to the issue of insecurity in this country, that there were some riots in Mwiki area about people who are protesting about bad roads in Kasarani Mwiki area. And I remember there was the Honorable Senator Johnson Sakaja went to talk to the people and to ensure that that normalcy comes back to that area, only to learn later that a human life was lost there. An engineering student, the hope of the parent, was killed just for demanding that we have good roads. Again, I flipped through TV channels, I flipped through newspapers, no one. Even when we went to visit, when Sakaja was addressing those people, he was only delivering a government message that the road is going to be repaired. And I remember what I said that time. Yes, what Sakaja has told you, I can confirm that the road will be done, but will that life be reclaimed? Yet no one is asking this question. Not the opposition, not the media, not civil society. Has human life in Kenya become so cheap? A day later, in a Majengo area, another human life is lost. Really, if we continue to lower the threshold of human life in this country, terrible things will continue to happen. And I want to call upon government, and I want to call upon media, I want to call upon civil society, I want to call whatever is left of the opposition, for people not to keep quiet. When you lose such crusaders for human rights like James Orengo to the parochialism of the day, what a loss, what a waste that you don't hear the rights of Orengo talking about loss of human life simply because he is enjoying the trappings of power. How many years will it take to produce another Orengo? How many years will it take to produce another Otieno Amolo? And I want to approach those few lawyers, human rights lawyers and activists, Harun Dubi, John Kaminoa, Dr. Ifuru Okot, especially, you know, who are studying with us on this issue of disrespect of court orders. Please stay firm and we are not alone. And I can see, I really want to see the coming together of progressive forces about this issue of, you know, abuse of human rights, return of the police states, threat of extrajudicial killings and political assassinations. These things must not be allowed to creep back to our civilized democratic nation. It has been now 28 years since we reviewed Section 2A, and we thought we did away with these things. We cannot go back there. We cannot allow Kenya to slide back to days of police states. But you know what? This is what happens. Every day something happens. Every day some rights are taken, we keep quiet. You remember the last time I was on this seat? Was on the issue of Miguna Miguna. And I told you guys about Martin Nimra and his story about the guy who said, I was not a Jew, not a socialist, not a trade unionist, so I was not speak. It didn't take me 3 days before I was in police cells. I think it was prophetic. It was prophetic. But this is exactly what is happening. Continuous, consistent, and gradual degradation of human rights, abuse of court processes, weaponization of prosecution, just to silence people. And I wonder the following. If all these threats are coming because of BBI, all of us have accepted BBI. I remember in 2010, I was a co-head of communication center for the Yes referendum alongside Salim Lon. Myself from PNU, Salim Lon from ODM. And we worked together and we planned all these rallies. We were planning for Kibaki, for Uhuru Kenyatta, for Raila Odinga, for all the people who are in the Yes campaign, irrespective of their political differences. There was no Yes campaign for Uhuru or for Kibaki or for Raila. It was one which we were organizing as a secretariat. But now what we are finding is that Kisii, they had their own one side, partisan, political partisan side. We saw what happened in Mukungu. Even Governor Waihuru said she's a member of the National Steering Committee. In fact, I was so very good. I think it was a slip of the tongue because she was not meant to say. It was supposed to be some nuclear secret of some sort which accidentally fell off. And now we know that a secretariat has been formed behind our backs. Yeah? So it is not necessary. And I'm saying to all anxiety to hear, it is not necessary. We are all supporting of the PBI process. So it can only be that these so-called parties and meetings which are being planned are for some other different purpose or different reason. So it is not necessary. So there's no need of spilling blood. There's no need of assassinating people. There's no need of all these shenanigans. Because why? Why are we fighting about nothing? Why are two bald-headed men fighting over hair comb? They don't need it. It is not necessary. No one has refused BBI. And personally, me anything just to show, I hear they are in Mombasa this weekend, I will be there. I will go to Mombasa. Because I believe that if it's the same BBI that you're talking about, it is one I'm supporting. I will be there. But please, and this is my message to Haji and to the two principals by BBI, the president and the former prime minister. Let us stop the sideshows. We are supportive of the BBI process. Publish the calendar, publish the schedule, and so that you see, because you can only try too hard if there's a reason. And there's nothing that stops people from Tangatanga in Nikisi, like the Tangatanga, Tangatanga in Kakamega, like the Tangatanga in Bukungu, let us Tangatanga in Mombasa and elsewhere. There's nothing wrong with Tangatanga in the whole country. Because what's happening right now is Tangatanga. Yeah? The Tangatanga in Kisi, the Tangatanga in Bukungu, and we will Tangatanga together in Mombasa. Because it's a BBI for all of us. So, summary, please. One, please, whoever is going to associate me with this, because I have explained here, I am going to take action. I'm going to take legal action on this. Two, let's stop taking this country back to the dark old days of repression that we have come from. It is not necessary. Three, we are all unanimous in supporting BBI. If we know what BBI is, and if we assume BBI is a document that came from bombers. If it's something else also, we're going to have a card in the mesa to own it. What's all these shenanigans? Instead of just put a card on the table, say, I want prime minister. I want, like they are saying now, they want to create 500 constituencies. Let it happen. To own it. So, for me, I support the document that came from bombers. The only thing I would put my hand to change is to add economic issues, our milk, our coffee, our tea, our potatoes, our bananas, our rice, yeah? BBI bombers plus BBI uchumi. You deserve the support. We match BBI bombers, which came from bombers, BBI uchumi, which we have been singing about all this time, and we move forward to the country together. If it is still possible to achieve a national consensus. But you know what? We cannot achieve a national consensus if we continue hiding all the dangerous cards, as the late Michael Kijana Wamalwa would say, below the table, and only put the safe cards above the table. No. Tufunguliane roho, jamani. Tufunguliane roho. Instead of taking the country through these shenanigans, threatening people, cold threats of assassinations and that, we don't need this. If it was necessary, we'd understand. But I don't think we're at that moment where we can now say we want to create more of the Bombais. It is not necessary. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.
I have a question.
Yes.
You talk of the issue of the BBI secretariat. Are you calling for a joint secretariat with the...
Of four players, all stakeholders. We are ready. Yeah? So that we plan for meetings. We plan together. We plan together. If it's about political campaigns, everybody can do their own thing. Because you can't force people to do their politics together. But anything in the name of BBI, it should be joint. Either joint, ama tuseme ni soko huru. Tuambiwe sasa, like Paul said to the Philippians, go and preach the gospel anyhow, as long as you're preaching the gospel, whether with a good intention or a bad intention.
Question. Has the secretary dictated in with you? And if yes, what's the next step?
You know, the president recently signed a law, the Parliamentary Service Commission bill into law. That bill, and I invite you to go and read, says that there is going to be a police service unit within the Parliamentary Service Commission. In other words, it's a responsibility of Parliamentary Service Commission to provide members of parliament with security. So I cannot even respond to that because I can only ask Parliamentary Service Commission. So those are the people who legally, not out of favor, are going to, I will ask about anything security related. But let's move beyond that, my friend. Why when people get kila siku na tuongeze mambo yako, why do you glorify us as members of parliament? Eh? Why can't we talk about insecurity generally? I don't want this to be about members of parliament. I want this to be about the insecurity in the country. It's not about me. Me, I walk in the streets. I walk on River Road alone. I have no reason to fear anyone whatsoever. My conscience is white as snow. But before you just make a lot of, mountain out of molehill, one, this is an issue of Parliamentary Service Commission. As members of Parliament, we have just left them to handle this issue because my privileges are administered by Parliamentary Service Commission. But two, really, let's really put focus on the wider insecurity facing Kenyans. Let's put focus on that university kid, that engineering student who was shot in Mulki just for demanding for a good road. Yeah? Let's look at all the people who go through muggings and house breaks and, you know, this kind of, let's go through people who go through police brutality every day. Once we go through that, I'm ready to address the issue of my security.
My second question and my final question is on the issue of Msandu. After you recorded a statement 2 days later, you were summoned. Have the police ever summoned you again?
Not at all, that ended there. And more important, you have never followed up with the police, Mr. Grisayo.
Okay, my question is concerning Msandu. During the then vibrant opposition, leaders led by Raila Odinga and a few leaders in the company from the government claimed that it was the government that was behind the killing of Msandu. According to you, maybe, do you feel it was indeed the government, and what exactly might be the motive of what eliminating Msandu?
You know, I'm not an investigator, but now that you mentioned that Raila Odinga and the president asked about it, probably you need to go to Capitol Hill and ask them whether they followed up now that they're in government.
You gave us a very old story of Msandu'S and the meetings that which happened last week. I understand that John Sakaja talked about that thing on last week, and now you are talking about it. From where you sit, has there been any threats, intimidation, or someone? What was made you now that you have come to tell us?
Actually, you know, the reason I've come forward is just because every time I speak about issues, you guys say Msandu'. And I recorded a statement dutifully, and I was there offering information, so nothing triggered, but I didn't want to put this issue to an end. And Moses Kuria'S is not someone to be threatened, my friend. I'm unvocal.
Mheshimiwa, I will ask a question. Why now? And then number two, I don't know if it's you who love starting controversy, but the last time Miguna was being deported, again, it was sort of controversial. You were seen in the same plane with him. How come it is you?
Let me address the issue of why now. Mm-hmm. The issue of why now is because you have never followed up on Msandu'S murder in the media. I was giving you a chance.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, media should also say we have failed where they have failed. Media is dropping the ball consistently. People are being killed, Mwiki, nothing, no coverage. Instead of Buhungu, Kisi, somebody dies and you know, you're not following up on it. You tell me why now, up to why now? It's better me you have come. You, why, up to why? When is the last time you went to DCIO? Let us see Msandu'S file. How have we written it? I can't do your work.
Mm-hmm.
And on that, in terms of Miguna, I was in my family going for a holiday. I didn't even know Miguna was there. I tried to say hi to him and he told me, go away. That's all. You didn't cover the issue of this student. You don't even know where he comes from. You don't even know when he's going to be buried. You don't even know the family. You are supposed to.
The mother was interviewed. That means we know the family. There was interviewed.
There has not been pressure, my friend.
I'll send you the link. But my question is.
To result is a masori. I like that one.
Yeah, my question is.
Do you agree with me that people should not die in vain?
People should not die in vain.
Thank you very much.
My question.
Sorry for interviewing you.
At this point in time. How do Kenyans trust you? Because you are the same people who put this government in place, and you are the same people now shouting of its shortcomings. How do people trust you?
This country, this government was not put in place by us. It was put in place by voters. Yeah.
But you championed for
6 million voters, and what you are supposed to do, according to your script, is. Even if we find shortcomings, he said, let me shut up, because I'm the one who voted for this government. That's not the way it happened. Then why do we change governments? Why do we change governments if we are supposed to keep quiet and then In any case, I think we did the right thing for voting for this government. Because those people who told us not to vote for it are in it. Despite all that's happened.
Would you vote for it again?
Well, thank God Jubilee government is coming to an end. So, well, let's move forward. Yeah. I am disappointed. I think that's a good question, my friend. And what we need to do is vigilance. Vigilance, vigilance. Threats will be many. Persecution will be a lot. But as me, I was a student. As a student leader, I was a student leader of the University of Nairobi. We were in these streets during Saba Saba. Even some people who were in government were not in government that time. They were not even in politics. I really want to come call upon those people who are my masters, my teachers. Raila Odinga was my teacher. James Orengo was my teacher. Paul Moti was my teacher. Is this what you taught us to do? To watch by as injustices happen? What about if you all give in to the conspiracy of silence? Simply because I would say I am a member of parliament and I'm in a privileged position. It's not my business. Then who's going to speak out? We keep quiet as politicians. You keep quiet as a media. Civil society is dead. Then who now? Who will speak to for this country? And I think we had made so many tangible steps forward from 2010, even the day the time passed, because every day we were becoming better than yesterday. Every year since 1991, since December 1991 at Kasarani, despite many challenges and many pitfalls, this country has always been better than yesterday. But sadly now, every day that's passing, this country is becoming worse than yesterday. That, you know, what can I say about it? Babu, you know, was arraigned in court today. You know, he's been in court. I'm just saying, killing is bad. Whether it is done by a politician or whoever it is, it's bad. But what was done today is what would I have asked for? That justice is done. Have I ever had a problem of going to court? I dutifully respect court and I go there and argue my cases. I prove my innocence. I think Babu will have his day in court. Is it that or that you want? You want my rule or the rule of law?
Mheshimiwa, leo hiyo time we have been to Matanga, the BJP.
Meru? We welcome meetings everywhere. And I tell you, once they are published, ata usiniite, nitakuweko. With or without security. Because the government my security and guarantee your security. Yeah? To put that in Mombasa. Because if the subject is BBI, you should say come one, come all. Come as your mambo ngine. I think that's all. Yes.
You must say utakuwa Mombasa weekend ijayo. Iwapo utafungiwa.
Kufungua kwenda wapi? Kwa BBI? Ukilifungia biguni, nitaleta shida. Hili hapa duniani hawezi kunitisha.